Good morning. This is a reflection for the 7th of June. If you feel rather bereft of the Holy Spirit in these anxious times, can you take comfort by turning to the words of Jesus about how to live your life? My favourite part of the New Testament is from the Sermon on the Mount in Matthew chapter 5. This is an extract taken from the Good News Bible. Happy are those who are merciful to others. God will be merciful to them. Happy are those who work for peace. God will call him his children. I take these words of Jesus as the way to try to live your life, as the ultimate thing to strive for, accepting that I will fall short. A faith based on attitudes and actions. A faith with responsibilities. Have you read the short book of James in the New Testament? Although he was not one of the 12 apostles, he's thought to have been the brother of Jesus, and he certainly knew him. He was the first bishop of the church in Jerusalem in the early church. I feel comfortable with the words of James in his section on faith and deeds. We've had the reading from quite a long section of James. The idea is that if you have brothers and sisters that have no clothes and are starving, there's no good in saying to them, God bless you. Keep warm and well if you don't give them the necessities of life. Or in verse 26, so then as the body without the spirit is dead, so also faith without actions is dead. Historically, influential people in the early Christian church have looked at the material of the New Testament and have attributed more authority to some books and letters than to others. Often James' written word appears to conflict with Paul's beliefs. Martin Luther called James' book in the New Testament an epistle of straw because it appears to teach salvation by good works. With St. Paul came the theory of salvation through grace, which was at odds with the thoughts of James. But there is a suggestion that this has never been part of the official orthodoxy, that is salvation through grace, and even now is not in the church creeds. It is suggested by John Barton in A History of the Bible that Martin Luther rediscovered Paul as an inspiration for his own theology, since in which the interpretation of Paul has been dominated by Lutheran themes. The theory of salvation through grace was espoused by Luther in 1517, and he felt so passionately that this was the only way to redemption that he wanted to downgrade the book of James and actually take it out of the New Testament altogether. Luther based his views on Paul's letters to the Romans 3:21. This righteousness from God comes through faith in Jesus Christ to all who believe. There is no difference, for all have sinned and fall short of the glory of God and are justified freely by his grace through the redemption that came by Jesus Christ. This is justification by grace through faith alone. This concept became the central plank of Lutheran reform. Of course, at the time of Luther, people thought they could buy redemption by paying into the church coffers, a rich man paying his way to salvation. And Luther felt that the Catholic Church of the time had become discredited by these practices. Luther believed that nothing human beings could do, however good in itself, could please God. But nothing was needed, since he granted salvation freely without price. One could say, perhaps, that this could lead to a theory that once one has been justified through faith, it doesn't matter how you behave. Although Paul cannot be accused of believing this, since he always stressed the importance of a moral life. You could look at Galatians 5:19-23 or Romans 13:8-9. The Lutheran concept that without the whirlwind of the Holy Spirit, one is doomed, however one lives one life, has never really felt right to me. I remember well an announcement many years ago by someone in our church that whilst commuting from work on the number 100 bus travelling from Oxford to Longhanborough, they were suddenly miraculously converted to Christianity, a life changed forever with the Spirit. I thought, this is an exclusive club that I doubt I can ever join. For me, the Sermon on the Mount and the words of James give great comfort. As we hear such heartwarming stories of people helping each other in these difficult times, we may reflect that they are following the words and instructions of Jesus. The words of James might resonate with you and give comfort, particularly if you, like me, have never recognised a number 100 bus moment, but rather have had precious but brief moments with Jesus scattered throughout your life. The Church of Scotland is a broad church, and it can include us all. Let us allow the words of Jesus to comfort us in this anxious time. God bless you. Amen.